She was the last born in Nora's troop in 2023. One of the most beautiful girls born that year. And very clingy too. Her mum and grandmum would protect her at all costs. She carried the bloodline for her family. A most precious girl. I remember it was a sweltering day. That even your many cousins, aunts and uncles had to take refuge in a man-made structure. When I first noticed that you had arrived here, on Monkey Hill. And there you were, with your mum, B. A tiny thing you were then. All I could make out was a dark, furry thing hanging onto Mum's chest. Just as I thought that was it for our first encounter, a goodies van had arrived. There it was, making its way along the dam. And there you were again. Your mum had just brought you back. And so there you were, finally. Bebe. As your mum was leaving with you, I was hoping that I would see you soon again. But that didn't happen until nearly a month later. just before dusk when I was about to leave. And there you were with your mum. You had to be about a month old then. And I could also see that your developmental milestones seem to be on target too. And you were one gorgeous baby in a dark coat. I took to you immediately. You reminded me so much of your deceased brother, Benji. A rebirth of Benji again. As much as I wished I could see you more often, it wasn't until another 2 weeks before I could bump into you again. But the timing was better. I saw you with your mum not long after I had made my way along the dam. And what a gorgeous baby girl you were. You were the cutest girl out there with Desiree. The next time I saw you, it was in the middle of September, nearly a whole month later. You were then about 2 months old, and was still very clingy to your mum, B. But I could see that you were trying to figure out the world around you. And you weren't slacking. You were picking up skills here and there. Learning to forage too. And when everyone decided to go forage in that luscious green field there, you seemed hesitant first. You were dragging behind Mum too. You seemed undecided at first to join or not. But in the end you went along with your mum. To socialize at first. And with a little bit of encouragement, and teasing, you finally found a world outside the comfort zone of your mum's warm chest. And you began to put to the test skills you've picked up from your mum too. Oh well, at least it is a start. And I had no doubt you would join them comfortably soon. It was a pleasure to see how you grew, and how your personality began to map out. A week later, it must have come to you as a great shock. That Mum would leave you with your aunts to do errands. And there she was, with your brother Banjo. Poor Bebe, you had no idea that this was coming, at some point. It was like an infant's first day at a nursery. Some would adjust well, others would cry their heart out. Bebe belonged to the latter. And finally, back in the arms of Mum and Grandmum. Bebe just couldn't do without her mum on her first day at a nursery. Poor Bebe, you couldn't bear to part with your mum for a sec. What could mum do with you? It's tea time, and I was on my way back the same day. Your grandmum, mum, and brother. Where were you hiding, Bebe? A good sign though that you were now playing away from your mum. Ah, there you were. You seem to have picked yourself up following what had happened earlier on during the day. Or not really. While all your peers were mingling and playing, you were on your own, with mum nearby. Bebe, that shelter, your comfort zone, could be gone one day. Could little Bebe take her first tentative step outside that comfort zone? It would be another week before I bumped into you with your mum again. There you were, with your mum. That very first tentative step would always be the hardest. There were dragonflies flying everywhere. Soon it would be October. And you would be 3 months old too, Bebe. And would you like to become Nessie? But that's only possible because her mum Locke has a tattoo on her chest. Nessie will be her last kid forever. Still, Bebe, I had confidence that you would take that first step yourself. And there you were again, Bebe. Not much progress, was there? But time was ticking, Bebe. Some weird changes with your mum were about to come. Your mum would then be torn between you and an urge so strong, she might find herself unable to resist at all. The first warning. Bebe, I hope that didn't hurt. Oh, look at that. So far, so good. But Mum was going to become decisive. Whether you like it or not. Hooray! Bebe, you had done much better than I could imagine. You seem to be less clingy already. And more inquisitive too. You seem to have caught up with the other older babies too. Go, girl. It's time to let them see you with their equal. It seemed B had done a great job here, or time had. Whatever the case, Bebe, you should make it through the mating season when Mum wouldn't be around as much by your side. Look, that's Bebe. up. Bebe, you were going to do just fine. Even without Mum in sight. A month nearly went by before I could bump into you again, though. Then another 3 weeks went by. And just before the year 2023 came to an end. You were limping along with a gash on your left leg. Then I saw you once again in the first week of January, 2024. You were still limping along. But the gash had nearly all healed up. And I thought I was going to see you in a much better shape the following week. Little did I realize that was the last time I would ever see you again. Bebe, the beautiful girl with brown eyes and a dark coat. You will be missed forever.